Hello friends, welcome to Tutorials Point. In this video we will learn COBOL data layout. Now this is the agenda. We will learn redefines clause, then rename clause, then uses clause and then copy box. So we will first start with redefine clause. So it is used to define a storage with different data description. So if one or more data items are not used simultaneously, then the same storage can be utilized for another data item. So what's the purpose of this? Suppose if you are using a data variable and that variable is not used frequently. So in that scenario, what we will do is we will redefine it, and when we will redefine the new variable, that new variable will point to the same memory location. So the starting point for both the variables will be same. So we will see in this example. Here you can see ws old pick x of 10. This was our one variable which we are not using simultaneously or frequently. Then we have ws new redefines ws old. So here you can see redefines, and this is our keyword. Then we have ws old. So here you can see that was x and now we have declared as 9. Still it will work. The reason behind is because we are using the memory location, but the values in both the variables will remain the same. So and also with the redefining item, like with ws new, we cannot use value clause. Also, it cannot be level number 66 or 88. We cannot define a level number 66 or 88. Then in file section, do not use redefine clause with 01 level number. Redefine definition must be the next data description you want to redefine. Suppose if you have ws old and you want to redefine it, then it should be the next statement. And redefining item will always have the same values as a redefined item. So whatever value you will place in ws old, the same value will reflect in ws new. The reason behind this is because they are pointing to the same memory location. Now next is rename clause. So this is used to give a different name to existing data items. So it can be group item or it can be elementary item. The only condition is the level should be same. If they are at same level, then only we can rename them. And we have a reserved level number for this. So level number is 66. 66 level number is reserved for renames. So renames definition must be the next data description you want to rename. It's same like our redefines. It should be just immediately after the description, after the variable which you are renaming. So here you can see the syntax. Ws old, in this we have 10, A, B and D. Now what we will do is we are creating one more member at 66 level, ws new, which renames ws a and ws b. It is grouping a and b. So in ws new, the values of ws a and ws b will be stored. Now next is uses clause. So uses clause specifies the operating system in which format data is stored. So it cannot be used with level number 66 and 88. If uses clause is specified on a group, then all the elementary items will have the same uses clause. So we have different uses clause like display. In this, data is stored in ASCII format and each character will take up to 1 byte. So suppose if you have given, you have declared one variable and it was 9 of 5 and you have declared uses as display, then it will take 5 bytes. Then we have computation or com. Data items is stored in binary format here. Here data items must be an integer. Now we will see different comp types. We have comp 1. In this is similar to real or float and is represented as a single precision floating point number. Internally data is stored in hexadecimal format and comp 1 does not accept pick clause. So here one word is equal to 4 bytes. Similarly for comp 2, it is similar to long or double and is represented as a double precision floating point number. Internally data is stored in hexadecimal and comp 2 does not specify a pick clause. Here 2 words is equal to 8 bytes. Then we have comp 3. The data item is stored in packed decimal format. Each digit occupies half a byte, or you can say one nibble. One nibble is equal to half byte and the sign is stored in the rightmost nibble. So in the rightmost nibble, the sign will be stored. Then we have copy books. So COBOL copy book is a selection of code that defines data structure. Suppose in many programs we are using the same data structure, then you do not need to write it again and again. Instead, you can create a copy book and simply you can use the copy command, and that same structure will be pasted here. So here you can see working storage section, we are just writing copy ABC. So whatever content, whatever data structures are present in ABC, they will be copied here in our working storage section. Now let's see all these functions practically.
We will start with redefines. I have coded one COBOL module for redefines, renames and copybooks. So we'll discuss them. Data layout, open in edit mode, do a reset. In working storage section, we have WS name member and its picture clause is AO15, alphabetic 15. As discussed, redefine clause is used to define a storage with different data description. If one or more storage data items are not used simultaneously, then the same storage can be used for another data item. I have redefined WS name RED redefines WS name pick X of 10. It can be more than A of 15 or it can be less than as well, and it can be of same length also. What it will do is, suppose WS name is having a 15 byte in the memory, then it will be pointing to that 15 byte and the starting position of both the memories will be same. Both the bytes basically. So suppose it is starting from a one particular position, then it will take 15 bytes from there, and WS name redefine will start from the same position but it will take only 10 bytes. It will be more clear when we'll execute this program. There are certain rules for redefines. Level numbers of redefine items and redefining item must be same, and it cannot be 66 or 88 level. Here we have given 01 for WS name, so 01 for redefine also. Do not use value clause with a redefining item. In redefining item, we cannot use a value clause. Here you can use a value clause. This WS name RED is a redefining item and WS name is a redefined item. Redefine's definition must be the next data description you want to redefine. And a redefining item will always have the same value as of a redefined item. So we'll play with values here. What I've done is, first of all, I have displayed what is WS name and what is WS name RED. What are the values inside M? Then I have moved tutorials point to WS name. Then we'll check again what's the value in these two, redefined item and redefining item. Then I have moved .com to the redefining item here in WS REM red. Then we'll see what will happen. We'll check the values for both. Then this one is for rename. Rename clause is used to give different names to existing data items. Suppose we have declared one group item 01 WS number. So WS number is pointing to, it is starting from WS num 1 to num 4. It is of total 8 bytes, 2, 2, 2 each. Suppose I want to make one more data item which starts from 2 to 4, then we can use this by renames. Here we have renamed it WS rename, and it is starting from num 2 and num 4. The values from num 2 position to num 4 will be stored in this, and we can modify them if we can change the value of this variable. This is always defined at 66 level, rename level is 66. There are certain rules for this. Renaming is possible at the same level only. Suppose this we are renaming 0505, then it should be 05 only. We cannot rename 01 and 05. We cannot club them. Then we cannot use renames with 177 66 level number. Like you cannot rename again this 66 level. Here in this program, what I did is, first of all, I passed this value to WS number. What will happen is 11223344. So this will be distributed here. Like num1 will be first two characters as it is size is 2. Then the next two will be num2. Next three will be num3. Then next will be num4, 44. So in num1 we will have 11, in num2 22, num3 33 and num4 44 values. So when we'll display this WS rename, we'll get the values starting from 2 to 4. So we'll get the values 2, 2, 3, 3 and 4, 4. Next is copybook. Here you can see I've defined one copy structure. So in this program, in this working storage, you cannot see WS last name. I haven't given any variable here, and I haven't assigned any value or assigned any variable here with WS last name. Here you can see this, but still I'm using it and I will not get any error. The reason for this is in this structure member I have already defined WS last name. So what copy statement does is it will copy the content of structure in this program, and then it is a part of this program only. So in this copy book I have defined WS last name, so I can use it directly here. So we'll execute this and then it will be more clear. We'll first compile this. So this is the copybook PDS. Here you can go and see. Edit. Here I have defined WS last name, which will be copied into our program when we'll compile this. Go to compile JCL. I have made some minor changes in this module. I have added one palm for library, as we have introduced one copy library, and I have added this line syslib. Here I have mentioned the path of copybook. In syslib I have mentioned the path of the PDS where our structure copybook is present. So it's tutorial.point.copy, which we have just seen. So we'll submit this. You got max CC 0. Now we'll execute this program. First of all, we'll see the output of this compilation. Go to spool. We'll see how our load looks like. We'll go to COBOL step. This is our compile step. Here you can see 66 rename, then this copy structure, and it has already added this WS last line in our program itself. When you go to end, you cannot see any errors. So now we'll go to our JCL to execute this program. And we'll submit this. Max CC 0, it's success. We'll open our COBOL module and from there we'll see like how the execution happened. This is our module data layout. Do a reset. We'll now check the spool. So this is the first statement. Display the name and redefined item. You can see both are blank because both are pointing to same location and both does not have any value at that location. Now next we have moved tutorials point to WS name. Here WS name was of 15 character, you can see it here, and redefined item is of 10. So in 15 you get this tutorials point, but it was of 10, so only 10 characters are displaying tutorial SP. In the next step, what we did is we move .com to the redefining item. So WS name redefine, we have moved .com. So now we'll see. Here you can see .com and then some spaces and then OINT. What happened is we have added some value to this RED. WS name RED, and what happened was it replaced the 10 characters because its size was of 10. So .com followed by spaces. So the first 10 bytes they were replaced by .com and spaces, and the last 5 we haven't touched it. We haven't moved anything into name. We have just moved to RED and it was of 10 characters. So .com, that's the reason here you can see the last 5 bytes as OINT because it was previously there. So this is about redefine. Then in the next statement, we are moving the values as we have discussed this earlier. So we'll check the value of rename. Here we are renaming from 2 to 4. Here 2 is 22, 4 is 44. 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. So in rename, we have a value 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. So it has renamed from num2 to num4. So we got this value in rename. Then in copy structure, we just displayed last name and we are getting the value here. As we have already seen in copybook, we have stored value Jim in this character, in this field basically. So we have got the value here. So this is all about redefines, rename and copybooks. In the next video, we'll start with condition statements.